So I lost a deal for $800,000. I had both sides of it for 3%. I revived a deal in the 700s I have both sides of, $40,000 commission, closing soon. And I put one under contract with some buyers I've been working with for a few months in the 400s. All this happened yesterday. What's up everybody, Ricky Carruth here. Welcome back to my channel. So I want to start documenting my real estate business a little better for you. Okay, I want to start sharing some of the inner details of a lot of my deals and listings and so on and so forth. So yesterday I had those three situations, so I want to share with you a little bit more about them. Also, I want you to know I'm going all in right now on my podcast, okay? The Zero to Diamond podcast, it's everywhere. I'm gonna put links in the description to iTunes and SoundCloud, but you can find it anywhere, and I'm gonna be posting there every day. And it's content that you will not find anywhere else. There's a lot of content on there. Some of it we do repurpose for other platforms, but not all of it, okay? So go there, subscribe, give me a 5-star review, let me know what you think about it, and I hope it brings you tons of value. So let's get into these three different situations that happened to me yesterday, and then I want to give you my 2 cents. First, the deal that I lost, that literally fell apart, it was in the 800s, and I want to disclose the exact price, but it's a house down here, okay? It was my listing, all right, and I had a buyer for it, okay? This buyer was from another state. Okay, he said he didn't want to be represented by an agent. He didn't even want a referral fee. He just wanted me to get the best deal possible for him. So as we're going back and forth here, this was about a month in the making. We finally go under contract last week. Okay, he drives down, looks the house over, we do the contract, but we negotiated the whole deal before he got here. All right, and this guy was a heck of a negotiator. He got us down and down and down. My seller got down to a point where he wasn't coming down anymore, and then he came down a little more just to make it happen. He really had to think long and hard, so he really stretched this out, the buyer did. And the seller made it clear that this is an as-is deal. Okay, this was as-is. Do not ask me to fix anything on this house. Don't come up with any little repairs, you know, inspection items, nothing. This is coming to you as you see it for this price. Now, on my end, okay, I had to actually cut 2%. So I had a 5% listing, and I ended up doing both sides for 3%, which I was fine with. Okay, I did what I had to do. I did my best to keep it at 5, to keep it at 4, right? And the way that it all came down, 3, I was fine with 3%. Okay, no problems there. I would rather have more, but hey, I'm gonna take what I can get and I'm gonna try to make the deal work so that I have a deeper relationship with both the buyer and seller. Remember, I have 2 clients here that will do future business with me, okay? So I'm keeping in mind relationships over transactions. So he comes down, he takes a look at the house, okay, he signs the final contract, okay, so now we're completely under contract at this moment. And, you know, a couple days later, he goes back home, a couple days later, we're going back and forth on emails, and there were a few issues with the house that he had problems with, okay, and so he wants to come back with, you know, to spare you all the details here, was about $3,000 worth of stuff. And I'm thinking in my head, you know, you got us down to a price. I came off my commission 2%. The seller says it's as is, and now you're gonna possibly walk away from a deal over $3,000 on an as is deal for a house in the 800,000s. Okay, so it just made completely zero sense to me at that point. But here's what I did. I thought about it, I slept on it, okay, and the next morning, I woke up and I emailed him and I said, look, man, you know, this is an as is deal, all right, but I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll split that $3,000 with you. I'll give you a $1,500 credit. That way you can do all the repairs after closing, because this guy was a builder. So, you know, you need to do the repairs yourself so that you're fully satisfied with the workmanship. All right, and I'll give you $1,500 on my end. I'll split it with you, okay? So this is an as-is deal. Now he's getting half the repairs, you know, taken care of. I'm thinking this is a done deal. This guy's gonna do this. There's no way he's gonna walk away for $1,500 on this house, which is a good deal, by the way. It's a waterfront house. It's on a canal that goes straight to the bay. You can get a big boat in there. You know, it's exactly what he's looking for. At the end of the day, he said, I'm walking. I'm going to back out of this deal. I don't feel comfortable with certain things. So who knows what exactly happened there. You never know what's going on inside someone's mind, right? But I did everything I could do. I got it down to where we had an agreed on deal, right? I squeezed on my side. I threw in some for repairs, still couldn't make it happen. Look, you win some, you lose some. The name of the game is to do the best you can do, right? To make the deal happen, you go as far as you can go with it until they either buy or die. You go until they buy or die. The next deal that I revived yesterday, okay? It's in the 700s on both sides of this one, all right? And it's a $40,000 commission. Okay, so not too shabby. It's supposed to close tomorrow. A couple days ago, I get a call and the buyer's gonna back out. They just have this bad feeling in their gut. Their gut's telling them not to do this deal. Okay, and I'm just like completely blown away. This is a cash deal. All contingencies have been met. You know, we're down to the final week. We're about to close. And now they're just having buyer's remorse, really. They're just having buyer's remorse and, you know, who knows, you know, like I said, who knows what's going on inside someone's head. So what I did, okay, watch how I played this. What I did on this one is I literally was nice to the buyer, okay, representing both sides on this one. I was nice to the buyer. I didn't try to make them feel bad. I didn't threaten them. I didn't come at them any kind of weird way. I just said, no problem. You know, let me see if I can try to get you out of this contract. Because at this point in the contract, she's bound to the contract legally to close. You know, the sellers are going to have to let her out of the contract. And so, you know, some sellers may threaten to sue in those kind of situations. You know, who knows what somebody would do, you know, with that kind of deal going on. But what I did was I was just nice to the buyer. Okay, and I called the seller. I told them what was going on. They said, man, that is frustrating. Let us sleep on it. Okay, and after all was said and done, just cutting to the chase here, sparing you some of the details, the buyer called me back and said, you know what, Ricky? The biggest problem that I'm having and the most anxiety I'm having about this is that there's so much furniture in there that I just don't need any of it. Okay, and it's just, it's giving me so much anxiety worrying about what I'm gonna do with it, how I'm gonna get it out of the condo. And I said, listen, I'll take care of that. All you have to do is just tell me these things. I can have some guys go over there with a truck, empty that place out so you got a clean slate. No problem. So she said, okay, let me think about it. Let me sleep on it. I think I'm back in the game. All right, I'll call you tomorrow. So that was the day before yesterday. So yesterday, I ended up talking to her again and she says she's back in the game. It's not gonna close on time. We're gonna need about a week extension or so because she, you know, put this halt to it all of a sudden. But it looks like we're gonna close this one. So I really wanted to get this one worked out because, you know, for the sake of my seller, it's a really good deal. The appraisal came in over the purchase price. Okay, and I can get all the furniture out for, so let's go. So I'm really excited about that one. We'll see when it's gonna close. I'll find out today. I'll start to put the pieces of the puzzle back together on that one. But this other one that I put under contract with the buyers I've been working with for several months, okay, went under contract on a 2-bedroom on the beach in the low 400s. It's a really nice condo, fourth floor, you know, looking at the beach, beautiful view, beautiful condo. All right, and this is something that they are really gonna enjoy. They have kids, younger kids, and they're just really, I'm really excited for this family. Now, this other one I put under contract yesterday was a family that I've been working with for a couple of months. All right, they've drove down. This was the second time they came down this past weekend. Looking at the same complex, they've been focused on this one complex. All right, we looked at a few that they picked out there and they went for it. They went for a 2-bedroom right on the beach, fourth floor, beautiful place. They have younger kids and I'm really excited about this one because this family's really gonna enjoy it. And one thing I really enjoyed on this deal, getting this one under contract, is how I negotiated the deal. Okay, I got the sellers to come way down off of what they said was their firm price. Okay, so they're asking one price, we offered this price. They came to this price and said, we're firm here. And I said, okay, well, here's our next offer. And they said, nope, we're firm here. I said, well, we'll meet in the middle, okay, but that's our final offer. Okay, it was about $5,000 difference. They said, we'll come down to $3,000 away. All right, so now they come down under their firm price that they stayed at twice. I said, let me give it a second. Let me get back to you. So I gave it some time and I went back and I said, nope, we're firm right here. And so the seller slept on it and boom, they came down to a price that I felt like when we first started negotiating, I told the buyers, I said, you know, if we get it here, I'm gonna be pretty happy. If we get it here, I'm gonna be extremely happy. If we get it here, I'm gonna be over the moon. Well, over the moon is where we got it. And these particular buyers were actually happy at full price. They said, you know, Ricky, we're happy what they're asking, so anything you can get off of it will be fine with us. So they kind of let me have the reins and kind of said, look, we're in your world now, all right? you do what you have to do, get us the best deal, and let's do this. So today, I'm getting all the HOA docs to them. I'm ordering an inspection, and they're sending the earnest money in, wiring it to the title company, and all the other stuff we have to do as real estate agents, as we get a deal under contract, to move to the next step towards setting everything up for the big closing. Okay guys, I'm gonna do a video like this every so often, kind of updating you on a couple deals I got going on. I hope you got some kind of value out of this. Comment below and let me know. If you wanted me to make more videos like this, kind of documenting my deals a little more, and that'll help me, you know, try to figure out if I want to do more of these types of videos. And like I said, please go and subscribe to my podcast. That's where I'm really going all in with content right now. I think that's where you're going to find some of the best value, bang for your buck, if you will, when you're looking at my content, listening, watching, reading. Okay, so you guys have an incredible day. Get out there and crush it. Go sell something. Go create some relationships. Just do it. Just do it. Quit thinking about it and just go. With that, let's go.